Symptom development of yellow sigatoka can be broken up into five stages. Stage 1 is a narrow yellowish green speck, about 1 millimetre in length, on the upper leaf surface. Stage 2A and 2B is when specks develop into streaks, 3 to 4 millimetres long and 1 millimetre or less in width, running parallel to leaf veins. Stage 3 is when the streaks broaden to become a spot, which become longer and wider without a defined margin. Stage 4 is when the spots may be water-soaked in appearance and turn rusty red or brown. As the spots develop, you will notice a definite dark brown edge. The center becomes sunken and is sometimes surrounded with a yellow halo. Stage 5 is when the spots then further develop into mature spots that still have a sunken center and turn gray, with a dark brown to black border, sometimes with a yellow halo. The disease produces two types of spores, conidia and ascospores, which germinate on the leaf surface. Spore germination is dependent on environmental conditions and occurs with temperatures over 20 degrees and a high relative humidity of close to 100%. Conidia are produced on the surface of stage 4 spots and form in the presence of rain or dew. They are dislodged by rainwater, spreading the disease to other leaves on the same plant or nearby plants if the rain is wind-driven. They move down with the drops and settle in the folds of unfurling leaves. For this reason, they spread only a short distance and usually result in a line spotting pattern on leaves. Infection from conidia mainly occurs during cooler periods of winter and early spring. This means infection during this period is mainly from plants within your own farm and is not attributed from neighbouring properties. This offers the best chance for growers to get on top of the infection cycle. Ascospores are produced on mature spots, stage 5, and are forcibly ejected during wet weather or after heavy dew. The greatest number of ascospores are released after rain that follows a prolonged dry period. Unlike conidia, ascospores can be dispersed by air and drift upwards in air currents and settle on the undersurface of leaves, mostly near the tips. For this reason, they are believed to be responsible for long-distance spread of the disease and result in a tip spotting pattern on leaves. The time it takes for the disease to develop depends on environmental conditions, the susceptibility or resistance of the variety, and the intensity of infection. However, generally, the period from infection to first symptoms can be 20 to 70 days, depending on temperature and moisture. The disease develops more rapidly during hot, wet conditions and takes longer during cooler, dry conditions.